But then I'm going to take that list and give it to a local agent I have a relationship established with, instead of picking an agent on Zillow or one of these online platforms. You know, so they're picking and choosing, you know, what makes their life easier with technology. Well, you know, we're back to this, you know, relationship, you know, centric industry, I believe. You know, technology has come in and played a cycle or two. And what we've done as an industry and as a consumer is we've taken these cycles of digital that's happened, these technology cycles in the market. And what we've done is we've picked out the parts that we like and the parts that we don't like. You know, like we went through a couple rounds of, you know, buyers basically choosing random agents online, and that ended up not being such a great thing at the end of the day, you know, percentage wise. You know, so now the market's leaning back towards picking an agent they know, like, and trust, and has created this bond with and this relationship with, and feels like they're a friend or family member. We're leaning back towards that. So that's one thing. Okay, we may take I'm going to find all my properties on Zillow, but then I'm going to take that list and give it to a local agent I have a relationship established with, instead of picking an agent on Zillow or one of these online platforms. You know, so they're picking and choosing, you know, what makes their life easier with technology, and they're using that to speed the process up, and it makes everybody's life easier. But then they're falling back to the old school, you know, methods in certain things that they didn't like about technology. And then as time goes on, there's going to be new technology come into the market, right? And we're going to have to evaluate that as a consumer, as agents, to see what we like and we don't like about that technology that comes into play. So, you know, it's very interesting. I think the consumers just want an agent that understands what their needs are, and it really listens to them about what they're looking for, you know, what they want to happen, and an agent that is empathetic towards their situation. You know, some agents aren't. They're very, you know, cold, calculated, you know, get the deal done, close the deal. But the agents, you know, and those agents, a lot of those agents are just sales agents. They're not necessarily building a brand. They're not trying to build relationships. I know a lot of these agents, they do exist. Like they, you know, they don't do anything to stay in touch with their database. You know, they're literally just prospecting for the rest of their life, trying to get the next deal, the next deal, the next deal, but they're not taking those deals and accumulating them as relationships in their pocket for a rainy day, you know? So I think consumers want just agents that care at the end of the day. They just want agents that care and will stay in touch with them, answer their phone, let them know when stuff's not going right, smooth the deal out for them, you know, get them what they feel like is the best negotiated deal. I went back to roofing houses. I worked on an oil rig. I served tables. I went bankrupt. I was sleeping in my car. I was eating out of people's refrigerators. You know, that's what I did. Okay. So I read 100 books because I was so curious to why I failed, because I felt like I was one of the hardest working agents in my market. I feel like I wanted it, you know, more than most agents. I feel like, you know, I was honest. I'm doing it for the right reasons. You know, I felt like I was a great agent. Why did I go from being on top, you know, or at least headed to the top, you know, and then just get completely knocked off back to the bottom, starting over at negative? And when you go bankrupt, that means you owed money that you couldn't pay back, and you had to file a court judgment to get out of that debt. Okay. So I was negative. How did I go from, you know, on top of the world to negative, you know, being one of the hardest working, honest guys out there? Well, I had to go back to the drawing board, right, and try to figure out what and piece it all together. And I'll tell you, a lot of things that I learned through that process and reading all those books and watching and thinking about how everything went down and trying to piece it all together, you know, outside of the things I did wrong, what I realized is that, you know, when you go through a moment like that, of course, I was in my mid-20s, and there were guys that were 40 and 50 and even in their 60s that went through the same exact thing. here I was in my mid-20s going through what they were going through in their 40s, 50s, and 60s. And I was like, wow, how fortunate am I? I wasn't worried about it. I was still in my 20s. Like, I could still go out till 7 in the morning, wake up at 8 o'clock, go roof houses, feel fine. Like, I was still in that, you know, time frame of my life. So it wasn't a big deal to me. I didn't have a family. I didn't have any bills. I was in a very... I was very blessed, to be honest. I mean, and I knew it at the time. I was like, you know, this is incredible for this to happen to me right now. Subconsciously, not on the front end. I wasn't thinking that. I wasn't telling everybody, like, thank God, you know, or anything. But
definitely not
that time. I definitely knew that on the inside. And a couple things I realized when you go through something like that, it makes you realize a lot of things about business. Okay, and one of the biggest things I realized was that regardless of any market conditions, because that was the worst real estate crash that we've ever seen in our life. If you even go, you know, through the scariest moments in our life here in terms of markets, you'll find that if you go back through your MLS, closings happened every single day through those scariest moments. The market never stopped. The market slowed down, but it never stopped. There's still closings happening. Every closing represents two opportunities to represent someone, a buyer and a seller. So multiply the closings happen every day by two, and that's how many opportunities there are every single day in your market. Go back to 2008, like, that was a very horrible real estate crash, and look at how many closings happened every day. When you start to realize how markets really operate and how the cycles happen in the industry, you'll realize there's nothing to worry about when it comes to like a crash or like a market downturn or a cycle or a correction. Like, these things aren't to be worried about in terms of, are we going to still, you know, continue to be real estate agents? That's not a question. If you understand it, if you let it scare you into a place where you feel like you can't succeed, then yeah, you'll get scared, you'll make timid actions, and you won't make it, and you have to get out of the business. But if you understand this and you go more all in with, okay, like, it doesn't matter as the market changes and the cycles that happens, if a lot of people in the market know who I am and realize how hard I work and how honest I am and professional and dependable, right? And I've built my personal brand with all the people that you've talked to, that have created great first impressions with. If you have something on the back end to build that personal brand with them from there, you're golden, right? That's why I do the weekly email. It's every single week. Let me mute Betty. Bam. That's why I do the weekly email every single week on the same day of the week forever to my entire database to continue to build that brand. And that's how I've continued to sell 100 properties a year, is from that brand that I built through making all those calls to make those great first impressions, right? That's how the business works. You got to talk to people. I don't care where you get your leads from. You're going to have to, at some point, sit down and call a list of people. You do an open house. You're trying to develop a list to then call those. If you get online leads from Zillow or Facebook or wherever, you got to sit down and call the leads. You know, so it all comes back to talking to people one-on-one. That's how you scale your business, accumulate those relationships, and have something on the back end to build that brand with them forever, where they never forget who you are. New listings, right? You could be the new listing guy. Every week, you could have the new listings.
Okay, that's what
you're saying. That's breaking news. New listings is breaking news. You know, like, this stuff came on the market this week. Here's your list of new listings on the market this week. Who else is sending out new listings every week? Nobody. So what if you're Corey, the new listing guy? And every week it's like, you know, Corey's, you know, new listing update. Boom. Hope you're having a great week. I want to let you know, here's the new listings on the market this week. Click here. If you see something you like, let me know. If there's anything else I can do for you, please reach out. Have a good rest of your week. Talk to you soon. Boom. Send that out to your database every single Wednesday. And then sacrifice the business you might lose on the other 100 things to really focus on these 3 or 4 things. And I think a lot of you are probably really spread out with the different avenues of business that you're trying to do. So in 2008, I get back in and make that $80,000. The next year, 2009, I do $100,000. And then 2010, bam, the oil spill hits, the BP oil spill. You know, we had oil washing up on our beaches. You probably guys probably probably had some of that, experienced some of that if you were on the west coast of Florida. I'm not sure how far that went, but it was a scary moment. We really didn't know what was gonna happen. And this was my moment right here. This was it. I got to test out my theory that, because when I lost everything and came back, my thing was I wanted to build a business that would never ever get shook by the market. I wanted to have complete control of my business. I never wanted to be victim to something that was out of my control. I definitely never wanted to lose everything, go bankrupt, sleep in my car, and eat out of people's refrigerators. So when I got back in the business, one thing that I really recognized, and the reason why I lost everything, the real root of the reason why I failed so hard, was because that first part of my career, I was 100% focused on listings, sales, getting the contracts, closings, money. I was 100% focused on the money. And when I went through the crash, not only did I realize my friend was doing the same exact strategies he was doing before the crash and that succeeding at a big in a big, big way, I also realized that some of my clients that were buying and selling with me before I got out of the business were still buying and selling during that 2005 and 2008 range. And you guys are thinking, a lot of people are thinking, just try to sell this house. And if not, I'm moving on. Don't even collect data. Don't even collect data. Don't even do weekly email. Do nothing to build your personal brand. Just in this constant sales mentality. When you're in the sales mentality, you're only good as your last sale. You gotta wake up the next day and go sell again and again and again every day until you die. But when you build personal brand and you accumulate, when you accumulate clients and friendships and a database, right? And these people know who you are. They get your content every week. They know your opinion on the market. They know what restaurants you like. They know what properties you sold. Thousands of people in your market know all that stuff about you. You have a large business. And you can accumulate these people five at a time. Five new friends or property owners every day. 25 in a week, 100 in a month, 1,200 in a year, 24 in 2 years, 36 in 3 years, 48 in 4 years. In 4 years, you guys could all be one of the top agents in your market. But you're worried about getting, you know, 20 listings this year. When in 2024, 2025, you're not going to care what you did in 2021. Yeah, but you're only going to care what you did in 2024. And 2024 is only going to be dictated. Your success is going to be predicated by how many friendships you created this year and next year and the year after. So it just comes all back to the simplicity of, can we just talk to people and create be friends with people in the market, see what we can do to help them, offer them our services, and then stay in touch with them forever?